Hello guys, welcome to IAS guide. See, in this video we'll be looking into sociology optional 75 days online course for 2018 civil service exam, and this is day one and the date is 18th 8 2017, okay, 18th of August 2017, and this is part one. Actually every day now we'll be having four videos, okay. 75 days complete means into four, okay, in total 300 videos we'll be having. Okay, and this is part one video of day one. Okay, let's see what is there in this day one. And the contents are like this. The main subject what we are going to deal in this day one is modernity and social change in Europe and emergence of sociology. Okay, this is the topic we are going to deal in detail. And within this topic, we are going to deal with the concept of science. What is science? The different classification of science. Then next we'll be dealing with what is sociology, how it emerged actually, and what are the early characteristics that sociology was having. Then the next concept, factors which favored the emergence of sociology. Okay, there are various points, various factors are there. Okay, all these factors in detail we will discuss. Then we will also discuss the characteristics of social phenomena, okay, because social phenomena have unique characteristics, so that we will be discussing that also. Then at last we will be discussing about the contribution of the pioneers of sociology, okay, Comte, Spencer, Weber, okay, all these sociologists, know they are called as the founding father of sociology, okay, that's the reason. Their contribution to the sociology we will be looking into detail at the last of this day's video. Okay, first let's start about science and its classification. The question is, what is science? See, science is the knowledge, okay, but this knowledge, no, it is not an haphazard knowledge. This knowledge is a systematic arranged knowledge, okay. Knowledge can be anything, okay, it can be anything, and it can be acquired in any form, and it can be haphazard, but science means the knowledge which is arranged in certain order, certain systematic way, that is known as science. Okay, and we know that the knowledge is vast as ocean, okay. However, the deep you go into digging into knowledge, the deeper it goes, okay, that is known as, it is vast as an ocean. We cannot measure the knowledge. The purpose of science is acquisition of knowledge, okay, and also there are different methods to acquire this knowledge, okay. In totality, this knowledge is known as science, which is arranged or ordered in a particular manner, okay. This is the brief meaning of science. Then we also know that it is humanly impossible to actually master all the knowledge in science. You tell me, who is the person who can master all the subjects? Okay, one person I can give from my side, Abdul Kalam ji. Okay, Abdul Kalam ji, know, he got a degree in many of the subjects. Okay, certain exceptions are there, but actually speaking, humanly it is impossible for any individual to master whole of the knowledge which is present in this world. Okay, but anyway, we can divide those science into different branches for our academic study. Academic, for academic purpose, we can divide the science into different branches. But in reality, we cannot actually divide them. Okay, for academic purpose, we can divide the science into physical sciences as well as social science. Let us have a look into what is this physical science. See, actually, physical science makes use of scientific method. Okay, it deals with the natural inanimate objects. See, the meaning of inanimate objects is non-living objects. Okay, and also the physical sciences, know, they are more precise actually. They are more exact, and also they are less dubious. That means less doubt we'll be having in physical sciences. Okay, and the examples we can give, mathematics is a physical science, because in mathematics definitely living beings will not study. We will study about equations and all. Physics, definitely no living beings. Chemistry, chemicals. Okay, so that is the reason it is a study of inanimate objects. Okay, physical scientists, know, makes use of scientific methods in order to acquire knowledge. In physical sciences, scientists make use of scientific methods. There are 100% proper scientific methods in physical sciences. Yes, definitely. Chemistry laboratory is there. Physics laboratory is there. Okay, we can make use of the scientific methods. Actually, the scientists know in physical sciences, they conduct experiments to verify the facts. Facts can be verified. Even prediction is easy and accurate in physical science. We can make 100% prediction in physical science. And also, objectivity can be maintained in physical science. Okay, this is the overall view about physical science. Let's now go to the second type of science, that is the social science. Okay, see, actually social science refers to the application of scientific method of study of intricate and complex network of human relationships and forms of organization designed to enable people to live together in the society is known as social science. Okay, briefly, social science studies about human relationship and their behavior towards the society. Okay, in shorter meaning. Okay, social science deals with the study of human behavior and their relationship with the society is known as social science. Okay, but the formal definition is like this. It refers to the application of scientific method of the study of intricate and complex network of human relationships and the forms of organization designed to enable people to live together in the society. That is known as social science. And examples of social science we can give as history, political science, economics, sociology, all these are the examples of social science. We can also take the examples of social science as the psychology. Okay, all these are the examples of social science. Okay, actually to be social is to interact, to participate in group life. That is known as social. Okay, I will repeat. To be social is to interact as well as participate in the group life in the society. Okay, and all human beings know they are social. We will call your human is a social being. All human beings are social. People interact with other peoples in order to survive in this society. Okay, social scientists know they predict how people will interact in a given set of circumstances. They will predict, they will study, social scientists. Okay, they know in what circumstance how people will interact. Okay, the social science are less exact to tell. Okay, it is not more exact as physical science. We told here no, the physical sciences are more exact, we told, but here no, it is not the case in social science. It is less exact in social science. Predictions are not more exact. The whole of the society constitute the laboratory in social science. In physics, you can take one laboratory in one building, one room you can purchase and you can set up the laboratory in physics. In chemistry also, laboratory you can set up. But what about the sociology? Sociology laboratory is not there. Complete the society is the laboratory here. Okay, not one building or one room. Complete society is a laboratory here. Okay, and also social sciences know the focus on problems like they faces the problems like objectivity. Social science faces the problems like objectivity and exact prediction. These are the problems. Anyway, social science are important in promoting human welfare. Definitely we need social science to promote human welfare. We cannot promote human welfare by physics and chemistry. Got it? These are the overall meaning and overall explanation about social science. Okay, that's it. Let's move to the next slide. In next slide, we will be discussing then what is sociology. Okay, we got a meaning that you may say, sir, we got a meaning that sociology is a part of social science. But what is sociology actually? That's the question now. Okay, actually sociology, you know, it is one of the members of family of social science, as said earlier. Just a minute, guys. Yeah, here. It is one of the members of the family of social science. It has acquired a distinct status for itself. ओके एंड ऑल्सो सोशियोलॉजी स्टडीज जस्ट ए मिनट ओके Sociology studies the nature and characteristics of human society, its origin, the development of human society, structure of human society, and functions. Okay, like other social sciences know, sociology is also concerned with the life and activity of man. That's what it studies. Always sociology studies about the human society, origin, development, structure, as well as functions. And sociology tries to determine the relationship and interdependence between different elements of social life. Okay, that means different elements means what are the elements? The elements may be the interdependence between moral and religion in society and the relationship between economic and political institution in the society. They are elements actually, economic and political. And the interdependence and relationship between intellectual and philosophical theories in our society. Okay, all these are the relationship and interdependency which the sociology studies. I'll repeat the third point again. It tries to determine the relationship and interdependence between different elements of social life. And these different elements are moral, religion, economic, political, intellectual and philosophical, and so on. Many things are there. Materialistic, non-materialistic, like that. And also sociology discovers fundamental conditions of social stability and social change. You may ask, sir, what are these fundamental conditions of social stability which sociology discovers? Okay, fundamental conditions means it analyzes the influencing factors like economic, political and geographical factors. Okay, all these are the factors which influence the social stability. Okay, see, economic factor, political factor, geographical factor, cultural factor. Okay, these all factors know influence on man and his life. Okay, according to this influence only man will act. That is known as social stability. How the society is stable? Due to the influence of all these factors on the man, economic influence because of money, okay, and because of political system, because of the geographical system, because of the cultural system. Culture tells that what should be done and what should not be done, do's and don'ts, so that social stability will be maintained. Okay, and also sociology focuses on social problems actually. Okay, social problems. Okay, sociology focuses on social problems like poverty. Sociology, you know, always concerned with how to solve poverty problem, how to solve beggary problem, how to solve this unemployment problem, overpopulation problem, crime problem. All these problems sociology wants to solve. Okay, this is the broader meaning of what is sociology. Okay, that's it. Let's move to the next slide. Now let's see the definition of sociology. Okay, when it comes to definition, no, two important definitions are there from our side. Okay, the first definition is given by Auguste Comte, who is known as the father of sociology. And the second definition, no, very important definition is given by Maurice Ginsberg. Okay, these are the two very famous definitions. Other definitions are also there, which are given by the other sociologists. But these are the very important definitions. Okay, the first definition, August Comte tells that sociology, you know, is the science of social phenomena, science of social phenomena, subject to natural and invariable laws, the discoveries of which is the object of investigation. This is the formal definition given by August Comte. Okay, in fact, August Comte, you know, he wanted first to call sociology as a term actually. Okay, he want to call this sociology as a social physics, but afterwards he dropped and gave this definition. Okay, social physics he want to call it. Okay, and second definition, let us see, which is given by Maurice Ginsberg. He tells that this the sociology is nothing but it is the study of human interaction and interrelationship their conditions and consequences. This is the formal definition of sociology given by Maurice Ginsberg. Okay, actually first sociology established as social science in France, later it went to England. First sociology concept came in France only, then only it went to England. Okay, that's it about the definitions of sociology. Let's move on to the some more explanation of this meaning of sociology. Actually the term sociology was coined by Auguste Comte. Okay, a well-known French social thinker in 1838 in his book Positive Philosophy, and he combined the word socius, that means society, and logos, that means study of society. Comte, he is called as the father of sociology. We all know that. Okay, actually commonly if we take sociology is concerned with man, his social relations and his society. That is the common definition of what we can give. I will repeat. The common definition sociology is, sociology means the study of man, his social relation and his society. Okay. And Auguste Comte, Spencer, Emile Durkheim, Marx and Weber. Okay. These are the five sociological thinkers who are often called as founding fathers of sociology. Okay, see, Auguste Comte is known as father of sociology, but the founding fathers of sociology are these five peoples: Auguste Comte, Spencer, Emile Durkheim and Marx Weber. These are the five peoples who are known as founding fathers of sociology. Okay, that's it. Let's move to the next slide. See, in the next slide we will be studying about the early characteristics of the sociology. Early characteristic, what are the characteristics the early sociology which emerged in France and England was having? Okay, these are the characteristics. Let me deal with this one. The science of sociology was taking its shape to emerge as a distinct science in the second half of 19th century and early part of 20th century. Okay, this is the time where the sociology emerged. 19th, 20th century, middle sociology emerged. And according to Bottomore, the early characteristic of sociology are as follows. Okay, the first characteristic of early sociology is it was encyclopedic in characteristic. See, the meaning of encyclopedia means whole, everything. Encyclopedia.com, which gives everything, all the information. Okay, it was concerned with the whole social life of man. Okay, early sociology is not concerned with any particular organization and institution. It was concerned with the whole life of man, social life of man, and with the whole of human history. That is known as encyclopedic in characteristic. Okay, and the second point, second characteristic is early sociology, which was under the influence of philosophy, of history, and biological theory of evolution, was largely evolutionary in nature. Okay, see, the point to be noted is early sociology, it was influenced by philosophy actually. Okay, earlier to sociology, philosophy was there. Sociology subject was not there, philosophy was there. Philosophy was transformed into sociology. Okay, that is known as evolutionary approach. First philosophy came, and after philosophy, the sub-branch of philosophy transformed itself into sociology due to the biological theory of evolution. That is known as the evolutionary in nature. So early sociology is evolutionary in nature, which came from philosophy, which followed the biological theory of evolution. So the early sociology is known as evolutionary in nature. Getting? Then the third point is, the early sociology was generally regarded as positive science, similar in characteristics to natural science. Natural science means physics, chemistry, mathematics. All these are the natural sciences. So, sociology is also positive science. See, we know that physics and chemistry is positive science. Positive science means which has clear-cut methods, scientific methods. That is known as positive science. See, physics we have formulas, chemistry we have equations. Equations, chemistry equations, definitely it is real. Physics equations, rocket equations, everything is real. In the sense, sociology is also having method, which is real, like that. Okay, the early sociology, you know, it was regarded as positive science. It is not something kind of faltu type of explanation. Sociological explanations are real explanation which is going to happen in the society. That is known as positive science. Getting? That's it. I'll repeat it again. It was generally regarded as positive science, similar in characteristics to natural science. Next point. Sociology. Was virtually recognized above all as the science of new industrial society. You may ask, sir, sociology, how it was recognized as the science of industrial society? Okay, before industrial society, sociology was not there. You may ask me the question. Yes, to tell yes, because the concept of sociology emerged only after industrial revolution. Okay, whenever the industry concept came now in Europe, after that only the study of sociology emerged. Before this industrial revolution, the concept of sociology was not there. The concept of philosophy was there. Okay, even though sociology claimed itself to be the general science, it dealt particularly with social problems. Okay, sociology, you may tell that it is general science. But actually, it is actually dealing with the social problems of industrialization. You tell me, what will be the social problem of industrialization? Crime rates will be high in industrialized society. Okay, to solve crime rate, suicide rate will be high. To solve suicide rate, okay, these are all the social problems. Unemployment. To solve social problem, this sociology emerged. Why social problems came? Due to industrialization. Getting unemployment means what? Getting the transformation of agriculture society into industrial society. That is known as industrialization. That is the reason unemployment generated. To solve all these problems, sociology came into existence. Okay, and also political and economic revolution of 18th century is also responsible for the emergence of sociology. That is the reason. See, 18th century is a industrialized industrialization era. 18th century. That is the reason sociology is known as industrial society. Science of industrial society. Because of the industrial problem only society sociology study emerged. Getting? Then the next point is sociology, the early sociology is also ideological and also scientific character. Both of this it was having, early sociology. That means ideological means traditional conservative values. Sociology was also concerned with the conservative values, traditional values. But it was also concerned with the radical values. Radical means scientific character value. Okay, traditional peoples will tell that, come on, we will follow traditional customs. But the younger generation will tell, no, we will follow the scientific lines. Okay, that means conflict will be there. Okay, that means early sociology was also studying traditional concepts. It was also concerned with the radical ideas which emerged. Radical ideas, we can tell Marx. Marx is very good example. Radical idea, who actually promoted radical idea. Okay, various conservative and radical ideas entered into its formation, gave rise to conflicting theories, and provoked controversies which continue even present to today. Okay, that conflicts, no, traditional, you tell me, old age people and younger generation people, there will be always conflict, no? That conflict is there today also. Okay, younger peoples will tell that we are hardworking people. Older generation people will tell that no, we were hardworking, you peoples are very lazy. That kind of conflict will be there. These are the early characteristics of sociology. Okay, and in the next slide, that's it, guys. This is the end of part one. And in part two, we will be dealing with this concept, factors which favor the emergence of sociology. Okay, this we will be dealing in day one, part two. Okay, so up to this, it is the end of part one. Okay, let's meet in the part two video. Okay, bye. Hey guys, see, this was just a limited edition of the course. To get all the videos, to get the full edition, you people need to enroll in this course. And to get yourself enrolled, you have to go to my blog. Okay, this is the address of my blog, iasguideindia.wordpress.com. You just go to this blog. All the enrollment details are there in this blog. Okay, even the enrollment form is there. okay, you need to fill the enrollment form, send it to me and get enrolled. Okay, then only you'll be getting all the 75 days videos. Okay, you'll be getting all the other features like test series, okay, evaluation from my side, okay, all those things you'll be getting only if you enroll in this course. Okay, that's it. Let's meet with the next video with some awesome contents. Okay, till then, bye.